The Korthus, the Steps of Faith. I like the music here, though.
Type and cast.
What? You tell me you can do that all the time.
No, I can heal and type, but I can't, you know, when I'm inputting text, then it's not a priority. A priority is knowing, like, what.
Alright, so this boss is a little different from any other boss in the game, actually. We have to protect those holy wards. That's you, Peanut.
We claim the victory this day, or Ishgard falls. Accept the fury into your heart and defend this bridge with your life's blood.
So ideally, the tanks will want to pick up the adds and bring them in range of the cannons. This tank appears to be doing that, so at least for now. DPS don't really want to focus on them too much, though if you have some AoE abilities like Howling Fist, you can throw that out. For the most part, you just want to kind of attack the boss and he's going to sideways slice there and attack the cannons and destroy them. Those on cannons can get about three shots in before you have to get away from the cannons because it's going to explode and do damage to you. And then you just move back to the next set of cannons. And you got to be careful not to be under its foot like I just was.
I'm trying to get to you. I don't know where you are.
I'm right under the boss.
Why can't I heal you?
Good question. Alright. And nice. He'll occasionally stun the group. But yeah, as a monk, it's kind of annoying trying to get to his flanks, because you run the issue of almost getting stepped on a lot. So now that when he reaches this wall, he's going to spend some time just punching it. Well, kind of punching it. I just got stepped on again. I'm terrible. And your fellow healer is dead. See, he's using body slam. Yeah, he should break the wall now. So now he's gonna be on cannons again, so that's where once the stun wears off. Yeah, he stuns everyone there.
Yes.
Doing good on his health though.
Yeah, actually the damage on him is pretty decent. Anyway, once he destroys those, I'll head up the tower, and I should probably use Invigorate. There we go. I'll head up the tower and prepare the Dragon Killer. For the first Dragon Killer, which I actually saw someone miss the first Dragon Killer. Damn it, you were there.
Yeah.
Yeah, so after you destroy these, I'll head up the tower and prepare for this first Dragon Killer. There goes. Alright. Running up the tower. And it's a tall tower. He's almost in place. should be good. He's gonna feel that. Sorry, I was attacking the dragon there to ensure that he didn't get off that hard stomp ability. Should be okay. We might need another person on one of the cannons though, because I think Alastor was one of the ones on the cannons.
Yeah, I know he was. So, I think so.
Gotta make sure that they get tethered.
We need another person on cannons. Since you're already doing cannons.
It was the first thing I said when I entered this.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay,
saying we need another
person,
though.
I'm just healing.
Yeah, unfortunately, I cannot be on cannons and tether, so.
Or you can't be on tethers and.
And dragon killers, dragon. Yeah.
I can't get both. Hello.
Oh, somebody's moving up.
Whether they know when to do it or not. Guy has no idea what he's doing.
He might be able to get it. Oh, you got him. Okay. Damn.
Nope.
I fired anyway.
Someone disconnected, so we won't kill him at break three.
Yeah, this is the last door, the guy who is on the other kind of.
Alright.
That's why we needed.
I thought he died, and just didn't pick up the res. I don't know.
Yeah, you can.
Okay.
Well, they destroyed that wall quickly.
You're the only person who's dead right now.
Thanks. This may actually be a loss because.
It's a loss.
What?
She has 20% health left and we have one break two. And he's all the way at the end, isn't he?
Not quite, he's one more thing to break. I'm just gonna need somebody up here to do the snare this time, or we will lose.
Which cannon?
Eat both of them because the person who was doing snares last time has no idea what they're doing, and I almost.
Okay, well, this
both.
Guy's in the cannon.
Yeah. I mean, that's the problem. Like, I'll get there as fast as I can, but.
No, I'm doing it.
We still need one other person to do it, so.
I'll go on the left-hand side. Which side are you on, facing the dragon?
I'm already in the cannon.
Which side are you on, facing the dragon? That's not what I asked you. I asked you which side you were on, facing the dragon. Because you're facing it right
stairs.
Now. I'm not gonna... Well, I might make it.
I thought you were in a cannon.
Nope.
No, I died!
Oh.
I explained to you that you knew that I died.
Oh, why couldn't you have sprinted that?
Because you cannot sprint until you have an ability to sprint. That's why I didn't sprint.
Well, you don't need full TP to sprint, actually.
You wouldn't sprint very far if you didn't have it.
But... Okay, don't blame me, okay?
I'm not blaming anyone, I'm just saying it's very, very far
okay,
to get back.
Right now.
I'm not blaming anyone. I asked
okay,
questions.
Yes.
If it gets it one more time, we lose.
Well, that's
okay. Yeah. And we lost. Because people will not listen and do what we tell them.
Well, guys, the thing is, the person who said they were doing the other cannon disconnected in the middle of the fight.
But after that,
okay, like, just chill.
What is wrong with you right now? We're just explaining. You don't know, you should say something. There's nothing wrong with that. You've said it many times to them.
Oh, I'm having loads of fun, Silky. It's just other people in the group don't want to listen.
I'm having fun, it's just...
Okay, guess we're running right in.
Although I may be able to get both tethers if I start early, I don't know.
I can do cannons.
Well, the other tank was not tanking anything, but the healer was dying, so I don't know.
Well.
Like right now, the other healer is dying.
Yes, this dragon is a really big dragon. He's still
Wait.
Smaller than the actual Bahamut.
Do you know who pulled?
One of the tanks.
Can't do anything.
I'm asking one question.
I have a feeling this group is gonna fall apart, though.
No, we can get Gamma and I do the cannons. Should be able to kill him, because Dragon Killer does quite a bit of points, right?
Yeah, but our tank is not doing a great job with the whole tank thing either.
No.
Shit, I got stepped on again. All right. Bishop's at 68%. If you want a good view of the dragon, look at him when I get up on top of the tower. Here, it'll give you a good scope of just how big Bishop is.
Quick with that. Quick with that.
I did go up a little early this time. I was expecting him to start sideways slicing earlier.
No, you with the stun on the turtle.
Oh, I was just spamming whatever button was on cooldown.
Oh.
Or off cooldown. Oh, that's a little good shit.
Turtle just does an AoE that's kind of big, and you can, like, stun it.
Cool. Well, I did, because natural talent.
Sure.
Alright, he's almost in place to get shot. There you go. Time to shoot him. A hit? The monster felt that one by the Fury. Now's our DPS time for the group to pummel this boss as much as we can.
We should just LB2 him now, right?
Yeah, no reason
not to. Oh, we have it. It's all we have.
We won't be able to get at one before the end, although I don't know how good that is.
Okay, just wait until he gets up there closer to the cannons, then I'll run up and get ready. Sideways slice going out. All right,
no.
I am in place.
Yes, it's down.
Yeah, they can just release and run back. Like, people don't even notice in this group. And that is one thing that's like, why don't you know that?
Okay, get ready. He's gonna start.
Okay.
And here's our second dragon killer, successfully done because of Piamet and Silly.
Piamet.
And down he goes. Well, down it goes. The dragon is still alive, but significantly more hurt than he was a moment ago. Took 15% of his health off, almost.
It pulls up.
Yeah, but I wasn't anywhere near it.
The game felt
I was wondering why you were still standing there, because I was like, I see that.
No, you can get like 3 shots off before the AoE goes away.
Yep.
But
better
but I didn't.
Sorry.
Well, I was, like I said, I was out of the AoE for a couple of seconds. It wasn't there anymore. attack.
I mean, it did.
I am very aware of that. But like I said, I
wasted the LB.
That's alright.
No boss.
Hooray.
There we go. It is down. Yes, I'm not a huge fan of that fight simply because I don't think any of these people deserve a commendation.
I didn't get a commendation. Yeah, since I don't know who pulled. I mean, I assume it's the other tank, but they ran, like, through the dragon.
Alright, irrelevant cutscenes.
Sorry. Didn't know.
Hang on, I share screen. Silly, you can be this guy.
The dragons! They are withdrawing! Victory is ours! Nidhogg's greatest champion, slain. The Horde will not soon recover from this blow. But what of you, Nidhogg? Why did you not join your minions and make of this battle a slaughter? Have you grown so fond of the stench of your lair? Mayhap you prefer to have your allies fight your battles for you. You have a girl to do your bidding now, do you not? No matter. I shall slay Iceheart and all the rest. But I yearn to spill the blood of a great worm, Nidhogg, and only your death will sate my lance.
Alright, let's talk to Alpha Node. Miro! The dragons are routed, lest you wonder. The fighting at the Steel Vigil was also fierce, but my crystal babes were not found wanting. I beg to differ, I went there beforehand, buddy. Commander Levelier, Miro, true to your word, you arrived to aid us in our hour of need. On behalf of the Holy See and the people of Ishgard, I offer you my humble thanks. Though I would stay and lavish you with well-deserved praise, I fear I must oversee the aftermath of the siege. Not all the dragons are fled, and they are yet wounded to be carried from the field. Pray, let us meet anon, and I might express my thanks with proper courtesy. Dentral Livestream and Paler Ice, thank you very much for the auto host. I too would offer my thanks, Miro. Through your deeds, we have achieved a victory of singular importance. With the Dravanian Horde thus weakened and scattered, the threat to Ishgard has been greatly diminished. And mayhap, equally significant, the Holy See must now recognize the necessity of cooperation with foreign powers. Long have they barred their gates against the outside world, but I am confident that the day will soon come when Ishgard proclaims itself a member of the Orisian Alliance once more. Much have we sacrificed in our struggles against the Dragons and Primals, the Ashians and the Empire, but step by unfaltering step, we march ever nearer to our goal. And as ever, the journey is made with you in the van. The victory you have won this day gives us greater hope for the morrow. 'Tis a hope we shall sustain us to the days to come, and bear us past the many evils that yet seek to hinder our progress. Yes, we have done well, my friend, and I, for one, would take a moment to savor the enormity of our achievement. And the demands of duty, however, allow me little time for levity. Accompany Captain Ilbert back to Ulda and reassign those braves whose squads suffered heavy losses. You, my friend, have earned a rest at the Rising Stones. Pray return to Revenant's Toll and share your tale with Minfilia in person. Alright, we are going to go to the Rising Stones. Second attempt on that fight went actually fairly well, despite the DC'd person. But really, that's mainly because of Silly and Piamet. They expertly handled those cannons.
Yeah, I should have, like, taken the initiative to do it sooner. But, you know, I always think...
Well, you never know how good the other healer is going to be either. Like, I feel like a good healer can compensate for, like, a tank who's, like, only, like, passable on that fight better than...
Well, there's the issue of the person who did go to the cannons and didn't know to tether.
Yeah, the Black Mage ran to the cannons, and they were firing the cannon, but they didn't even bother trying to tether, so...
Yeah.
Anyway, here is Minfilia.
Miro, welcome back. Alphanode sent word of the siege, and of course of the role you played in ending it. Your deeds never cease to amaze me, Miro. Thank you.
Alright, do I want skill speed or spell speed?
Spell speed.
Alright. Administrative decision. Minfilia seems to loathe to put you to further trouble so soon after your last great excursion. This might be voiced. Nope.
You must be weary, Miro. And now may very well be your only chance to... Antecedent! A messenger from Ulda arrived with a missive for you. The royal seal, yours indeed. Ah, an invitation. On behalf of the Council of the Orisian Alliance, Her Royal Majesty Nanamul Namo invites the Science of the Seventh Dawn to attend a feast at the Royal Palace of Ulda in honor of Ishgard's recent victory. It would seem we are to be recognized for our part in lifting the siege. You, for your valiant efforts as commander of the adventurous contingent, and the Archons for their earnest attempts to arouse the city-states. Truly, I find it strange that the Alliance leaders should think themselves deserving of a place at such a celebration. All three refused to deploy their standing armies, preferably to stand hastily assembled companies of sellswords, many of whom perished ere the siege began. Are they truly so brazen as to seek to share in the glory of their triumph? Ah, but mayhap they simply seek a pretext to meet with the Ishgardians while the mood is yet jubilant. Such an occasion would be a present fine opportunity to press for Ishgard's return to the Orisian Alliance. We have scarce had time to mourn Mumbrita, and I for one am in no mood to carouse. But I suppose we must put away our grief for the good of the realm. Though you are promised rest, I fear I must insist that you also attend. It would be a strange celebration indeed if the victorious hero were not present. Pray content yourself with the thought that such occasions may bring about momentous change, and this without recourse to bloodshed. Tataru, if you would do me the favor of contacting the rest of the Silence. Of course, Antecedent. And please let me know if there's anything else I can do. Curious. I have never known Tataru to sigh at such requests. Could aught be amiss?
Quest accepted. Alright. Look for Tataru at her desk. Wouldn't that be better for just meet with Tataru at her desk? Is that making fun of her because she's short?
Yes.
I found these salivas are apparently only from treasure maps, and I've been killing mortals.
Tataru is conspicuous by her absence. Flamin.
Tataru, I believe she just stepped outside. Now that I think on it, she did seem rather preoccupied.
Search for Tataru in Revenant's Toll. Alright. Great, I gotta search for Revenant's Toll again. There she is.
Miro, it's you. I didn't mean to worry anyone. It's nothing, really. Well, it's not nothing exactly, but it feels like nothing compared to the tiring trials you and the others face every day. And that's why I should probably talk to Manphilia before things get any worse. You always know what to say, Miro. I'm glad we had this little chat.
All right, you know what? This reminds me of an episode of Garfunkel of Notes I watched the other day. They decide to have a double date, but then they decide that they're not going to say anything through the entire thing and see what happens. And the guys don't even notice. One of the guys plays the bar owner there from Deadpool.
Nice.
How do you get a sweet cat mount like I had? You gotta go talk to Master Felix near Baccarat. Alright, Tataru, what do you gotta say here?
My mind is made up. Yes, Tataru. You have my undivided attention. I've been hesitant to approach the subject, but what with all the recent excitement. But Miro made me realize that there's no time like the present, and time is what I'm here to ask you for. I am not sure I understand. If you wish to be excused from your duties for a time, then you have certainly earned the rest. But I suspect that lying abed is far from your intent. You know me too well, Antecedent. There is, in fact, something I've been wanting to try my hand at. Along with the adventurers and the Crystal Braves, the Scions are constantly being thrown into dangerous battles and deadly predicaments. Even Hori Boulder and Colton have been promoted from guard duty to fill our need for competent warriors. And so it seems only right that I too should acquire the power to defend myself and others more importantly. When I return, I shall be both your receptionist and your bodyguard.
Whoa! Hey! That's the first time I've almost been knocked to the ground by a Lollifel. I've never seen Miss Tartara so determined. Has aught befell that which I might help antecedent?
Not at present, thank you. Was there something you would ask of me?
Ah, yes. Pray excuse my distraction. An adventurer who was to join us for escort duty was injured while on patrol, and I fear we cannot properly defend the scholars entrusted to our protection without the aid of at least one more guard. Therefore, I humbly request that another adventurer, of the capable kind, of course, be assigned to our party.
Very well. I shall consider the potential candidates and provide you with a replacement as soon as I am able.
My thanks, antecedent. I take my leave of you.
Didn't even acknowledge me, huh? What a jerk. Alright, Minfilia, what do you gotta say now? An unexpected ambition. Minfilia is at a loss for words.
The power to defend oneself. Tataru has ever been full of surprises. Now that I think on it, I do recall Lirianje mentioning that she had developed an interest in Arcanima. Mayhap she hopes to gain admittance to the Arcanist Guild in Limsa Luminta? Yes, that will be the way of it. Would you be so kind as to journey to the guild and see that all is well? It is doubtless unwarranted, but surely I am not alone in my concern for her safety.
Alright, and her other quest. Where we are needed, Minfilia is eyeing you with a mixture of regret and desperation.
I wonder, do you perchance recall the commitment I made to furnish Hori Boulder with a capable adventurer? Well, I'm sorry to say that I have as yet been unable to do so. And now I realize that you are rather more than a capable adventurer, and that escort duty is frankly beneath a woman of your talents, but I have no one else to turn to at present. Might you be willing to forgo rest and assist us in this matter? Generous to a fault. I thank you, Miro. Now it seems only fair that I explain the import of the task in question. For some time, our order has employed a handful of scholars to travel around Yorza taking etheric readings, that we might better understand the impact of primal summonings. Naturally, it behooves us to ensure our employees' safety, and so we ask the adventurers in our service to serve as escorts. Rory Boulder and Coltonet were to act as two such escorts, as was a third adventurer. Alas, due to injuries, that adventurer is not presently fit for duty, hence my need to impose upon your goodwill. You truly are a pillar of strength, Miro. Rory Boulder will share with you the details of your task. He should be waiting for you outside. Be safe.
Alright, well, we're gonna go do Tatara's stuff first. So, heading to Limsa Luminsa and going to the Arcanist Guild. Downstairs? I think they might be downstairs. Ah, there's Tatara. Look, she has a nice new little outfit and a book.
Miro, what are you doing here? I didn't mean for her to worry. That's the last thing I wanted. Putting an end to such worries is precisely the reason I'm here, don't you see? I, Detaru Taru, shall become a great and powerful arcanist. And now, at Mistress Thevergrim's behest, I must go and complete a special training exercise until we meet again.
Master Felix is where you recharge what thing? Alright, now we gotta speak to Thubergheim. Thubergheim. That is a lady.
Greetings and welcome to the Arcanist Guild. Do you require assistance? So you are acquainted with our newest member. I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but I fear young Tataru may not be ideally suited to the study of Arcanima. Nevertheless, she would not be denied and goes now to undertake her first trial, a simulated inspection of three crates. A simple task, some might say, but one all Arcanists are expected to complete. A thought occurs to me, why not supervise Tataru's training? You are clearly an accomplished adventurer, and given your relationship with the girl, you seem an ideal person to have on hand. Your trial will be conducted at the cliffs south of Zephyr Gate. You need only observe at a distance.
No, Silky, that's not where you go to recharge the mirror. Okay, so, we gotta go out the Zephyr Gate. If anybody has made an Arcanist, or are interested in making an Arcanist, this is a funny reference back to the original quest they have you do. Where you go and inspect those crates. Now we're gonna see how Tataru does. Squirms and I shall observe.
Or Zero seized Pirate's Port, or she met her shining jewel. For to bring the smuggler's plans to naught, came the lass whom none could fool. Beat him with a backdrop, gut him with a gust, deck him with a downburst, go, carbuncle, go. Oh, are those crates I spy? And this must be the true test. But we're ready for them, aren't we, Carbuncle? Carbuncle? Come back.
Poor Tatara. Carmichael just fucks off on her.
I should have known you'd come here. You needn't say a word, your face says it all. I know you bore witness to my shame. Betrayed by my own carbuncle and left at the mercy of wild beasts. I must accept the truth. I'll never be a warrior like you or the others. I will inform Mistress the Virgin of my intention to withdraw from the guild. Arcanima, like so much else, is beyond me.
Alright, time to go back into the city. Do this, Squirms. And when I get into the city, I'll be resetting my recording and taking a short bathroom break. Silly. Keep the stream entertained. Make sure PMN does not read any weird stories. Be right back.